Hi everyone, here today to talk about subtracting signed fractions. That means fractions that are positive and negative. So you will need your fractions packet on page 4. It says subtracting signed fractions at the top. So we're going to take a few quick notes on these 4 problems today, and then you'll do some practice. So we learned when we talked about integers that all subtraction problems can be turned into their equivalent addition problems. And so we're gonna use that skill here. It makes subtracting with fractions so much easier to turn them into addition problems. So here we go. First thing I'm gonna do is look through my problem and see if I notice any negative signs or any subtraction signs. So my first problem has a negative sign up here with a 2, which is just where we want it in a fraction. And then it says subtract 5/7. So this is what I'm going to change. I'm going to change this subtraction to adding the opposite number, because that is how you create your equivalent addition problem. So your first number stays exactly the same, -2/3. And our second number, instead of subtracting 5/7, we will add -5/7. Yesterday we learned to bump that negative sign up to the top of our fraction, so that's where I'm going to write it. Now that I've created my addition problem, I now know I need to check for a common denominator. And I can see right here that I don't in fact have a common denominator between 3 and 7. So I'll take a second to think about what that denominator should be. And this lowest possible denominator is 21. So I write 2 new fractions with a denominator of 21 because I'm gonna have to change both of these fractions in order to have the same denominator. I'll ask myself, okay, how will I change 3 into 21? That will be times 7. And I'll also need to do times 7 to my top number. 7 times 3, 21. 7 times -2 is -14. Keeping track of those negative signs with some color here. On the other side, I have to multiply 7 by 3 to get to my 21, so I'll do -5 times 3, that'll be -15. Now that I have 2 numbers with the same denominator, I can add, so 21 firsts plus 21 firsts will be out of 21, and then I just need to add -14 plus -15. They're both negative, and so they get along, and so that would be -29. I can add them. When I get to my final answer, I just stop and think, hey, is this in lowest terms? And I think about the factors of 29 and 21, and it is in fact in lowest terms. 29 is a prime number, so only 1 in itself go into it. All right, let's look over at number 2. In number 2, I see quite a bit going on. I see 2 negative numbers being subtracted from each other. So the first thing that I'm going to do is change that subtraction into addition. And in order to do that, the first number stays exactly the same. And the second number, I add its opposite. So the opposite of -3/5 is +3/5. Once it's been changed to its addition problem, I deal with my negative sign there. So I'm gonna bump that negative sign up to the top of my fraction. When I've done that, I can notice that my 2 numbers have different denominators. So I'll create a common denominator. And for 6 and 5, the lowest common denominator will be 30. So I write a spot for that denominator for both fractions. And then I think about how I need to find the equivalent fractions for each. So I would need to take 6 and multiply by 5 to get to 30. So I also have to multiply by 5 on top. And 5 times -1 is -5. In my second number, I'd have to multiply 5 by 6 to get to 30, so I would do 3 times 6 is 18 on top here. Keeping track of that negative sign, because I know I'll need it in my next step. 30ths plus 30ths would be 30ths. And I add the top, negative 5 plus 18. 18 wins this battle, so positives win, and there will be 13 left over. And so my answer is 13 thirtieths. I pause and think for a second, what goes into 13, what goes into 30? And since 13 is prime, I know that I'm not going, and 30 is not a multiple of 13, I know I'm not gonna be able to simplify final answer here. Two more problems. So in number 3, I notice here that I am subtracting 2 mixed numbers. Subtraction with mixed numbers can be done, but the easiest way to do it is convert them to their fraction form. When working with mixed numbers, operations are easiest to do in fraction form. So we will do that first. If you remember, to convert a mixed number to its fraction form, you multiply the denominator times the whole and then add the top. So 3 times 1 is 3 plus 2 is 5 thirds. And then 2 and 1 sixth would be 13 sixths. And I still have to change this into an addition problem. So I have 5 thirds minus 13 sixths. I'm going to change that into addition. My first number stays exactly the same, and my second number becomes its opposite, so negative 13 sixths. I'm gonna choose to write that negative sign up at the top of my fraction where it's easiest to keep them for our fraction operations. Now I'm ready to go to make a common denominator here. So 3 and 6, my denominator would be 6. That is the lowest one possible. So I'm gonna need to change that first fraction so it has a denominator of 6. And that second fraction, I don't have to change at all. 3 times 2 is what gets me to 6, so I'll do 2 times 5 on the top to get my new number in terms of sixths. When I add 6 to other sixths, I get sixths. And I need to ask myself, what is 10 plus negative 13? Well, those are a positive versus a negative will not get along, so my answer is going to be negative because that's my winner, and I'll subtract and get 3 sixths. Looking at negative 3 and 6, I notice that they're both divisible by 3. So these can simplify. When I simplify this down, I see that my final answer, my best answer, is negative 1/2. In my final problem, here I have 3 numbers being added and subtracted together. So let's just see what I have going on. I have 1 is a negative number. And then I have subtract 1/4 and then add 1/2. So the thing I need to change is the subtraction. I'm gonna change that to addition. That means I'm going to keep my first number exactly how it is, negative 3/5 or negative 3/5. And I will change the number immediately following the subtraction to its opposite. So subtract 1/4 becomes add negative 1/4. But I will do nothing to change this adding on 1/2 because this, I would get a result here and then add 1/2 to it. So there's no subtraction happening with that 1/2. Now that I've changed my problem so everything has an addition sign, I'm gonna look for a common denominator for everyone and change all of my fractions at once. So I notice that 5 and 4, their lowest common denominator is 20, and 2 also can be turned into 20. So I'm gonna go for a denominator of 20. And notice here that I put a spot for every single one of those fractions. I have to change all of them, and they're all gonna require a different number to multiply to get there. So I will work through each of them. So 5 times 4 will get me to 20. And so I'll do negative 3 times 4 for that first fraction. That's negative 12. In my second fraction, 4 times 5 will get me to 20. And so I'll do negative 1 times 5 on the top. So that'll be negative 5. And finally, for my last fraction, I have 2 times 10 gets 20. So I'll do 1 times 10 on the top for 10 20ths. My fractions here are all set, and I know that they all have the same denominator. So 20ths plus 20ths will yield 20ths. And I'll add, working left to right, two numbers at a time. So negative 12 plus negative 5, both negatives add to make negative 17. And then negative 17 plus 10. So there's a battle there. Negative 17 plus 10, the winner will be negative, and I'll have 7 left. And so my answer will be negative 7 20ths. So as you can see, subtracting with fractions is a lot like adding with fractions, because we're going to turn all of our subtraction problems into those addition problems. You guys are going to get some practice today on pages 5 and 6 of your packet. So one hint here about page 5, there are addition and subtraction problems throughout this paper. These problems are coming in pairs, and so this is how you can check your work. The problems next to each other have the exact same answer, but that's a fully simplified answer. So when you solve this first problem and you solve the second problem, your answer needs to match. If they don't match, go check and see if you can find your mistake. And that's true for every pair of problems going down the paper. The problem and its partner have the same answer. So that is how you will check your work today. As you work on page 5, you can work on the challenge problems on page 6, or finish up any problems on page 3 that you didn't get a chance to finish yesterday. So I'll see you guys later, and I hope you have a wonderful day.